Chair recognizes the gentleman from Oklahoma.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. My amendment would simply delay the implementation of the EPA's E15 waivers for the remainder of the fiscal year, which would allow Congress time to address safety concerns related to the higher blend of ethanol gasoline before the EPA puts it in our general fuel supply. Despite alarming consumer, environmental, and economic concerns, the Environmental Protection Agency has approved a 50% increase in the amount of corn-based ethanol allowed in gasoline used by cars and light trucks manufactured in 2001 model year and newer. This is simply another attempt by the EPA to engineer ethanol mandates to drive ethanol subsidies forward. And yes, this is a mandate. The EPA has mandated that we use 36 billion gallons of renewable fuels like ethanol annually in our motor engines by 2022, and through incremental steps and backhanded attempts just like this, the EPA is mandating. The EPA's move from E10 to E15 fuel over the next several months is in effect a backhanded 50% increase in the corn ethanol mandate, putting consumers, engine makers, and gasoline retailers at risk. Gasoline station owners are terrified of how they will comply with this E15 mandate because not all of the existing infrastructure is certified for the fuel. Under the EPA waiver, they will have no liability protections. Quick Trip, a major gasoline retailer across the Midwest, which is headquartered in my hometown of Tulsa, Oklahoma, offers an unconditional guarantee on every drop of gasoline they sell. Because of the lack of liability protections, they will be left on the hook if someone puts the wrong blend of gas in the wrong kind of car. That will open up a litigation nightmare. Why do we want to further mandate a fuel consumers don't want and retailers are afraid to sell? This is a major consumer safety issue that could adversely impact up to 60% of the cars on the road today. It is also important to point out the environmental impacts of this as well. The higher a fuel blend like E15, the higher the toxic air pollutant emissions. Since ethanol contains just 66% of the energy that gasoline does, E15 will lead to an actual drop in gasoline mileage. The EPA has even said you get 5% less fuel economy with E15 than clear gasoline. The EPA has completely ignored calls from lawmakers, industry, environmental, and consumer groups to address important safety issues raised by the 50% increase in the ethanol mandate waivers. Putting the brakes on E15 is the right thing to do for the people that we represent. I ask my colleagues to join me in passing this amendment, and I yield back.